Yes, and welcome back on the Touchline, Bernardo Kumu right here. And on to our first segment of the interviews, we speak with Raymond Rob Kiprotich, who is the Assistant Secretary of the Retired Athletes Association. He's a former runner, 3,000-meter steeplechase, and also did serve the country during his running days. He's here with us to talk about his plans and also what's happening as far as athletics leadership is concerned and what are the opportunities that lie there. Life after hanging the spikes. Karibu sana Rob.
Thank you, Mr. Okumu.
Yes. Everything is great.
It's great.
I mean, looking at athletics today, right?
Yes.
Maybe ulikimbia miaka tano ama sita iliyopita, but still hiyo ni juzi sana, sio?
Yes.
But looking at athletics leo, kuna kwa mfano katika mashindano kuna Diamond League ambayo pia wamesema kwamba mwaka ujao wataimake competitive kiasi kwa kuongeza ile pesa ambayo alikuwa anapatia mshindi, sio?
Yes.
We have you know, the former 100 meters runner Johnson also coming up with the athletics series next year huko.
Yes.
Itakuwa Jamaica, na pia tuliona races kadhaa ambazo zilianzishwa this year.
Yes.
Yani wewe unaweza semaje athletics, how has it changed, ama unaona future athletics in, kwa, especially ule mtu ambaye anakimbia na anataka kushinda na si pesa anataka, lakini zile opportunities ziko sahi kwa wanariadha ambao bado wako active, unaweza semaje?
Okay, kuhusu riadha vile inaendelea saa hii, tunaona kuna mabadiliko mengi ambapo pia wanariadha wanatumia nguvu mwingi kufanya mazoezi, ambapo pia kuna mashida kadhaa wanapitia. Lakini ukiangalia maneno ya sponsors, tunaomba kabisa serikali waongeze kuhusu maneno ya sponsoring of the upcoming athletes.
Wait, I mean, ukiongea hivyo na ukiangalia labda Kenya, hakuna zile kambi za serikali, hakuna zile, like for example Uganda, sio?
Yes.
Where they train, what's the name of that place, Kapta, Uganda,
Kapta,
hapo nyuma
Kaptama, yes,
mali wana train, unapata. Yes. Kwamba labda serikali imeenda ikajenga center zao.
Yes.
za government where people now train.
Yes.
Imejenga tartan track, stadium.
Yes.
Kidogo hapo kwa athletes in those high altitude areas.
Yes.
Kenya bado haijafanyika hivi.
Kenya bado. Lakini wanajaribu with our Apple CS now. Is trying his all best to make sure that the sports facilities has been improved.
But hiyo ni kusema tu bado haijatendeka, sio? Watu watangoja mpaka lini?
And for instance now, and during holidays, secondary schools, athletes have been taken to various camps in all regions in the Republic of Kenya, of which is, that's a great achievement for now, and that's a new beginning, of which it is a radical beginning.
It's a radical beginning.
Yes.
Yeah, taking them to the camps, and especially,
yes,
we all talk about this particular race that you is your speciality.
Yes. In
3,000 meters.
3,000 meters.
Yeah? Your title ime tupotea.
Ukiangalia parapara kwa undani sana, mita 3,000 kuruka fiunisi na machi, imeenda chini sasa, imesiti kudorora. Aswa ukiangalia wakati tulikimbia na Ezekiel Kemboi, Kip Kemboi, Richard Matelonga and Freeman Kipruto, it was in the high demand.
Nini likuwa inafanya, nini likuwa, ulikuwa hapo katikati yao, sio?
Yes.
Nini likuwa ina happen ambayo labda unaone inafaa kuwa emulated?
Ile kitu ilikuwa tunakosa ni maneno ya kuwa sponsored, tunakosa sponsors.
Hiyo wakati nini kizuri kilikuwa kina happen?
Ile kitu kilikuwa kina happen.
Brimin, Ezekiel, Matelongo walikuwa na dominate, na wewe uko hapo nyuma. Nini ilikuwa ina happen mzuri hiyo time?
Ile kitu kilikuwa ina happen, hata na appreciate. The time was in the ice level. Kenya was well known for 3,000 meters for a long time, and it was really maintained for a long period.
Why was that possible? How was that possible?
Ukiangalia kwa undani sana, 3,000 meters steeplechase is a technique game. It needs to be observed, not like the other events.
I mean, what kind of technique does it need? I know endurance is one of them.
Endurance is one of them. There even climbing, different styles of climbing the hill.
Yeah, and I mean, yeah.
And also
I remember during the Olympic Games, one of the athletes alimiss your water jump akarudi nyuma.
Yes.
So I mean, but that's at the highest level, but during your time,
yes,
8.29 was your personal best, right?
That was my personal best time.
your time na tofauti na sai, what do you think? What maybe your time it's it, I mean,
if you look at nowadays, maybe during the rolls it's only a winner maybe around 8:15, but by then it was around 8:05, 8:00 a winner. So it is a big there is a big difference in time of finishing time. Yes.
Yes, and maybe dominance here, the Moroccan Sofiane El Bakkali, we saw him, you know, winning the Olympics, though he did relinquish it to Olympics, Lipita, but domination here, Kenya, how soon can we return there?
Kenya, if we have, it is something now, we have to sit down now, as a whole, as the Kenya Retired Athletes Welfare Associations, Masters, Athletics, Ministry, and the government, we have to stand together with the athletes, and the sky way forward now, because an individual cannot make this issue to be sorted out. If you look at the upcoming athletes, some have got sponsored, but many are under the deep underground.
They're waiting for their time, or what are they doing underground?
Underground, I mean. Not yet being found by the Nini. Yes.
They need to be supported.
To be supported. Either by government. For instance, if you look at my fellow athletes now, most of them, there is something what is called social stratification in athletics, in athletes, whereby the high class athletes have their own social class, whereby the middle have the middle class, and the one which is down have their own class. If that one can diminish the our nini of the country.
So akuna ile umoja.
We lack union there.
But heading to the Olympics, we saw Ezekiel Kemboi, I think, just build up to the Olympics. So Ezekiel Kemboi, even he was at the trials. At the Olympic trials, he came, and when the 1, 2, and 3 were picked, alikuwa hapo. I think the government or the minister of the time alikuwa anajaribu kumleta karibu. So tunataka vitu kama zile zifanyike.
Also, ukiangalia tena upande wa management, maybe management in Athletics Kenya, it is something whereby concerning elections and something else.
So uongozi sio.
So there is need to break monotony, because Kenya is a democratic country whereby there is need to play to follow the rules.
And Kenyans are also very litigious. They go to courts a lot. Anyway, let's talk about your biggest moment.
My biggest moment. I spent in 3,000 meters. Whereby also I used to, I was having so very many fans at Nyayo National Stadium, Kasarani.
Did you ever get a chance to wear the national colors in international competitions, let's say at the Commonwealth Games, Africa Championship, or even World Championship, or even the Olympics?
Yeah, apart from running nationals, I was invited for the first time to travel for New Delhi Commonwealth Games in 2010, 27 July 2010, whereby I was very discouraged on that day.
What happened?
A day after Kativa Day, whereby 3,000 meters Stupoches was cancelled while we were on the start line, and the former Athletics Kenya president, Isaiah Kiplangat, gave direct selection to Ezekiel Kemboi, Richard Kipkemboi, Matelong, and Freeman Kipruto, of which I was feeling very embarrassed because I was an upcoming athlete.
So, I mean, and that continues to happen paka leo, sio?
Yes, things just like that happens.
Ukiangalia kwa undani. But don't you think maybe federation hiyo time iliheshimu ile uwezo wa kina Ezekiel wako nayo? Juu walikuwa sure na wao.
But the tactics also change. Ukiangalia concerning doping issues. This is some things which have come together. Doping, you have to go through 3 tests, of which I ran for 2010 for the first time in trials, 2012 for Olympic, and 2016 for Olympic at Kasarani, 10,000 meters. Also, I ran 29. And also, if you look at the races I have run, I have never been tested, of which to qualify now for international event, you must go through 3 tests in Tope.
Yes, and maybe and when you miss
of
the common...
Most at least can fail to do those because of, I don't know, reasons. Maybe we have to talk with Tope.
Let me ask, when you miss the ticket, to and when Kemboi and Brimin and Matelongo are given direct tickets to New Delhi or Commonwealth, how did it affect you and how did you pick
it
up yourself?
It affects my morale.
How did you like continue again? How did you tell yourself what came even happen? I only
encourage myself and say, let me continue struggle till latestly whereby I've seen things are not progressing also in order.
At that time. So you never got a chance to wear the national colors, but again, you were big on the national trials and also an active athlete in your time, right?
Yes.
And also, right now, I know that you're the Assistant Secretary of the Retired Athletes Association.
Yes.
What does this association do?
Kenya Retired Athletes Welfare Association is a registered organization under Section 10 of the Societies Act. And this association also and cover all sectors, whereby retired athletes is not only as an association, but it covers different federation. For instance, in Athletics Kenya officials, they are retired athletes. If you go to Masters, they are retired athletes, but still active. And if you go to NOC officials, they are retired athletes. So this retired Kenya Retired Athletes Welfare Association is the strong association whereby it covers all association. Yes.
Does it also get concerned with the welfare of the retired athletes?
Yes, we are trying all our best, even though some time back there was a big challenge concerning how to manage retired athletes, because nowadays we find retired athletes are the most people who bring medals to our country, Kenya. For instance, we are with many people, for instance, John Ngugi,
the five-time world cross-country champion.
Five times world cross-country champion. Also, we have Charity Mue, who was the first lady in Nyeri to run with a man in early 70s, and he won. He was the first one in front of men.
As well as Waidera, the 1984. Waidera,
if we go to Isiolo, we have a Doi Bor who bring gold medal to Kenya. Up to now, he's unknown.
So let's
go to Kisii, we have Jalis Asad.
Yes.
Who bring also gold medal in Kenya.
Yes.
But finally, let me make only few names.
Yes.
I finalize with the one who bring gold, who called to Kenya and is a boxer. The first one to bring Kenya gold, a boxer. I have heard your story because I'm concerned about retired athletes, whereby the backgrounds now is living in a slum area, there is need to look for that.
Yeah, that was
like that and uplift.
The only boxer who brought gold for Kenya, I think, was Wangila Napunyi, and he sadly passed on in '90s. But again, there is Suleiman Bilali, who went to the Olympics. He's an Olympian, and also won silver for Kenya at the Commonwealth Games. Gold at the Commonwealth Games, that was in Manchester, 2002. Yes. But right now, he was a police officer. Things never went well for him. He's fighting to get back to the force and also have his life on the bounce again. But kama itakuwa mzuri. So do you handle such cases?
Such cases, I have given those issues recently, whereby now we are trying all our best to make sure that we can reach those people and raise their concerns. Yes.
So
now he's living in Tandora. I have already been told he's living in Tandora, and I have people who have told me where he shall give you the direction.
So do you have the structure? He retired athletes association ikona structure ya ku approach cases kama hizo?
Cases kama hizo.
Wale ma legends ambao kidogo wana need your support.
Yes. According
kwa
to
maisha
our,
baada ya kuacha kucheza.
Our constitution also cover us, whereby we have to uplift we have a welfare, and also we have to uplift the retired athletes. Through, we are using our according to our constitution.
Yes. So far, how will you say, because that's where I think association itakuwa more stronger when it goes for the welfare of the retired athletes.
Yes.
So,
but nowadays,
out of 100%, say unaweza sema mko wapi sasa?
So far we have a problem of reaching them, because there is need for financial support. We need so many things to reach those people, and only we kindly request even the government of Kenya, CS Sports, the president of the Republic of Kenya to see the welfare of the retired athletes in Kenya.
And
not only that, even the upcoming also. Yes.
Yes. Upcoming or lazima wajinue wenyewe, ama?
No. We have to boost them because we have to give morale.
Yes. Yeah, well, to support, but they should know that it's so tough coming up. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, so you retired at 34, and some of what was your reason for hanging the spikes?
And
the tough competition.
Because I have learned through, I have gone through some problems whereby.
At what point did you decide you're now going to hang your spikes?
Not even to hang my spike. You know, now I'm in a category of masters athletics, of which from 35
Fine,
years.
Fine, but I'm talking about when you're wearing national colors and you're going for the Olympic trials at that stage. A master doesn't go for the Olympic trials.
Oh.
Yeah, at what point did you decide that you're hanging your spikes?
Okay. At that time,
did you ever think about it for some time?
I was trying to represent my country.
Uh-huh.
After looking Kenya, we are capable. One day, when I was in primary, I have tried to run for the first time. I was trying to test my strength if I am able to run.
Again.
So I have tested. I find myself being the only person remaining in the old school.
Uh-huh.
Up to the district level. That's when I started running, when I was in Ngesumin Primary School in Kericho. Yes.
So Ukamwak, so now you hang your boots, but Kenya facing, I mean, we've talked about opportunities our retired athletes, athletics sana sana.
Yes.
Ni kama master, sio?
Yes.
And right now, kuna mashindano inaendelea Nyayo, sio?
Yes.
Selection, yes.
Yes, uko, kuna mashindano inaendelea huko Kenyatta University, ambayo pia niyo ni masters.
Wanachagua timu.
Those are retired athletes active.
Who go for masters championships,
yes,
sio?
Yes, they are selecting a team that will go to Florida early next year, first quarter of the year, next year, whereby they represent our country in all indoors. Whereby
yes.
I wish them all the best, because They are my fellow athletes.
Hata ungekuwa hapo ama 3000 meters Kipchoge si indo anyway.
It is there, but because of there was a problem, there was a rising, because even the arrangement was not, it was supposed even to be take place in Nakuru, whereby now there was a big delay, whereby I was not in a position to make this, and I was also covering some programs concerning retired athletes and other.
And as assistant, as just as we finish, as assistant secretary for this particular association, PMEKUA, at the forefront, ya kuitisha uchaguzi. But since the particular case is in court, so we won't delve so much into it. But what's the status ya administration ya uchaguzi kwa shirikisho la riadha nchini? Tunajua kwamba labda uchaguzi wa mwisho ulifanyika miaka 10 iliyopita.
Yes. Kuhusu riadha, uchaguzi wa riadha, maafisa wa, yani, Kenya, Athletics Kenya officials, was done on 2012. And it's supposed to be done on 2016, whereby even the retired athletes tried to push to forward through ICO. They requested ICO to be pushed forward due to under-18 2017, that was held in Kasarani. Whereby after that, there was also some people who blocked that election.
Yes. So what do stakeholders want? Kama nyinyi, my stakeholders, athletics, kama nyinyi, mnataka nini? Yes.
We also came in after 2013, as I was the secretary, in 2023, in December 23rd, I wrote a letter to the Chief Justice, Honorable Martha Koome, and to request to concerning these issues pending cases since 2017 in athletics. It was pending in High Court.
So how soon do you want elections to happen?
We only wait for the court ruling, maybe to wait for the ministry and also the court to give us direction, more direction. Because already I have requested it, and the Chief Justice acted within 2 months. The cases that was pending for a long period of time has been finalized within 2 months. That was on 7 March 2024, was ruled in ICO that by Lawrence Mugambi.
So, kuna light, there will be election, na uchaguzi utafanyika?
Yes, there is a ray of light now, as we see, even though it is a slow process, but we see a ray of light with our able CS. We have confidence in him. Even the President of the Republic of Kenya, we have confidence in him. And also, we only have to unite.
Na kutokuwa kwa uchaguzi, labda kumetatiza aje shughuli za athletics nchini?
Kuhusu maneno ya riadha Kenya.
Kutokuwa na uchaguzi, because office iko, sio?
Yes. Kuhusu maneno ya riadha Kenya, we have if something is stay monotony, mm-hmm. even people will feel
that. Inapoteza
same uzuri, applies to athletes. Uh-huh. Some even coaches may be uh-huh. embarrassing some athletes or using in different ways.
Uh-huh.
Yes. They are harassing.
Uh-huh.
So maybe at least I've been even harassed. Even mm-hmm. me, I was mm-hmm. affected one time,
mm-hmm.
of which it mm-hmm. is something not
mm-hmm.
good.
Mm-hmm.
Whereby, if mm-hmm. somebody that stay as an in that same position for uh-huh. a long period of uh-huh. time, uh-huh. it affects psychology. Even yeah. me, I was affected same way.
Kuna kuwa na uzo.
So yeah. we have to break that monotony to uh-huh. refresh the officials, uh-huh. even if they will come back, uh-huh. but we have to refresh.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So we need elections.
Well, we
so
need,
thank you so much, Raymond.
Yes.
Rob Kiprotich, yes. the Assistant Secretary for the Retired Athletes Association,
yes.
former 3,000 meters Stipoches runner,
yes.
who is now taking his time to agitate or fight for the rights of athletes out there, retired at 34. Thank you so much, Rob, for your time. Maybe one word as we go?
Yes.
What would be your one word?
Before I continue, before I finalize,
yes.
may I take this opportunity to only appreciate my peer who accompany with me is with us now here.
Rob,
and also, as a country, uh-huh. I appreciate all the government of Kenya for a big change now uh-huh. in sports.
Okay.
And we are way forward positively.
Okay, thank you so much, Raymond.
Yes.
We be expecting to have our second session of interviews with Cheza Sports, Soccer Academy, which is based in South B, an academy that has been around and produced a number of players who've gone to play for either top level clubs and even national teams. So keep it touchline, we'll be back.